The learning objective for this chapter is to understand the importance of good communication procedures on all levels in order to achieve safe and efficient ship operation. What is communication? Here is one possible definition. Transfer of signals and messages from one person to another with the purpose of creating an understanding, a particular meaning, or a certain reaction from the other person. If no reaction is received, we are talking about one-way communication. There are several methods of communicating. These are in writing, verbal, nonverbal communication, signs and signals, etc. Option 1 may be a clear and straightforward message or an ambiguous one, but normally is only one way and it cannot be clarified. According to statistics, as much as 70 to 80% of incidents and accidents at sea can be traced back to some kind of communication problem. Here are a few examples of possible causes of communication problems. Communication problems between personnel on the bridge because of different culture, native language, age, experience, etc. Communication understanding between bridge and engine personnel. Communication understanding between ship and tugs. Communication understanding between ships. Communication understanding between ship and VTS. Communication understanding between ship and ship owner or operator. Communication understanding between ship and authorities. Nowadays, when only a few ships are sailing with a radio officer, the bridge has become not only the main communication center for internal ship communication, but also the center for external communication services. This means additional workload for the OOW. And good communication skill has become even more important for the navigation officer. The main elements for establishing good bridge communications and teamwork are clear and precise messages delivered in standard maritime English, mutual respect and confidence between the bridge team members, a professional job attitude and share of the workload, good theoretical knowledge, efficient adoption of effective bridge practices and procedures, self-confidence. Since communication problems have been identified as a factor which often plays a major role in sea incidents and many other accidents, the communication aspect of ship operation has been addressed by many different bodies at regular intervals over the last century. Among seafarers, the IMO publication, Standard Marine Navigational Vocabulary, is probably the best-known publication about this subject today. This publication has been updated several times and is a very good reference manual on the subject. In the late 80s, a new communication idea was presented to the maritime world, namely sea speak. More than 1,000 people from 26 maritime nations participated in the research and work that led to the production of the sea speak reference manual and the sea speak training manual. The central principle of sea speak is that the receiver should be alerted to the type of message that follows at the very beginning of the message. This aim is achieved by the use of message markers. A message marker is a label which is attached to a message. This principle is entirely in agreement with the IMO recommendations, and the main purpose of C-Speak is to reduce communication problems between ships, between ship and shore, between ship and VTS, etc. C-Speak messages are formed entirely from words within the English language. The total vocabulary used in C-Speak comprises three kinds of words and expressions. The vocabulary of general English. Words in general maritime use. Words in specialized maritime use. C-Speak has seven official message markers. However, in connection with special operations, additional markers may be used. Question. Indicate that the following message is of interrogative character. Request. Indicate that the contents of the following message are asking for action from others with respect to the ship. Information. Indicates that the following message is restricted to observed facts. Intention. Indicates that the following message informs other traffic participants about the ship's intention. Warning. Indicates that the following message informs other traffic participants about dangers. Instruction. Indicates that the following message implies the intention of the sender to influence the recipients by regulation. Advice. Indicates that the following message implies the intention of the sender to influence the recipients by a recommendation. The officer of the bridge watch should have a general operator's certificate. For ships operating only in Area A1, a restricted operator's certificate is sufficient. The officer of the watch will be responsible for ensuring compliance with the SOLAS requirements, the ITU radio regulations, and any local watchkeeping rules. The VHF watchkeeping range is 20 to 30 nautical miles, depending on antenna height. All ships must keep a continuous watch on the following channels. Digital selective calling, channel 70. Channel 16, when practicable. Channel 13, when practicable. When within their ranges, ships must keep a continuous watch on the NAVTEX and digital selective calling medium frequencies. On these radio bands, voice transmission ranges between 150 and 250 nautical miles by day and a little more by night. However, digital selective calling signals can reach 600 to 700 nautical miles. High-frequency broadcasts have a nearly unlimited range. Ships must keep a continuous watch on distress and DSC frequencies, 4, 6, 8, 12 and 16 megahertz, according to their position. Ships equipped with a ship Earth station must keep a continuous watch on the satellite appropriate to their position. The range of satellite broadcasts is limited to non-polar regions. A radio log, containing records of all incidents connected with radio communications of importance to the safety of life at sea, must be maintained. The following information is normally required in the radio log. A summary of communications relating to distress, urgency and safety traffic. A reference to important radio service incidents. own ship's position should be noted at least once a day. Identities of other stations with which contact has been made. Problems due to interference, congestion, etc. Unnecessary transmissions, obscene language, etc. Radio equipment should be tested at the intervals stated by the manufacturer and in accordance with flag state requirements. Great care should be taken to avoid the transmission of false alerts when testing equipment. All ships should make a report to the relevant authorities when an incident involving another ship is observed or an incident on their own ship involves a discharge or a probable discharge of oil or of other noxious liquid substances above permitted level has taken place. A discharge or probable discharge of harmful substances in package form has occurred. A discharge during the operation of the ship of oil or other noxious liquid substances in excess of what is allowed has occurred. The officer of the watch should always be prepared for an emergency situation to occur. He must familiarize himself with all procedures. These should be refreshed and practiced as a drill at regular intervals. The officer of the watch should always remember that an emergency incident does not become dangerous until it gets out of control. The most important thing to do during an emergency is to stay calm, think clearly, and follow relevant emergency procedures. Follow standard procedures, which have already been practiced in drills. The officer of the watch of a ship that is likely to be engaged in the transfer of personnel or stores by helicopter should become familiar with the ICS. Guide to Helicopter Ship Operations.